How you doing, guys? It's Andrew at Elite Gaming HQ, and in this video is your PC build of the month. We're going to look at a $700 gaming PC that'll be a beast at 1080p games. I feel like we have a perfect storm of some awesome sales on some great parts that all put together would make a PC that anybody would be happy with.
Elite Gaming.
Just like most people that do these PC builds over YouTube videos, I have to give a little disclaimer. These are the prices if you were to build it yourself, and they don't include an OS. But what I find interesting is all these people that are making these YouTube build videos that probably don't even know how to build a computer. I've seen a lot of crazy stuff. Parts that aren't compatible, people that have probably never had to flash a motherboard CMOS or do anything intricate. They may have changed a graphics card or maybe some RAM, but they don't actually know how to build or program a computer. That being said, I actually built this computer for a customer a couple months ago. With a little slight differences, the case wasn't the same, the GPU was a different manufacturer but the same card, and he bought the computer because he wanted to play 40k Deathwing and games like Fallout 4. Well, with this computer, you will be able to max out almost every game on the market, and at the very least, play them on high in 1080p. Now let's get into the first part, which is the case. For the case, I went with the Thermaltake View 27. Now this is a very interesting, very awesome looking case. When it came down for me building my case, I went with a 460 Crystal, but I did have this case on my mind, and right now it's on sale for $61.99, and it's hard to pass this one up. And also, if you wanted to, you could actually get extensions for your PCI Express slot so that you can face your graphics card so it points out, so you get a really cool look. I just really like the flow of this case. How to wrap around acrylic side window really shows off some components. As you can see from the pictures, this is a very beautiful case, and at $61.99, that is a great price. Now, if you don't catch this sale and you end up getting it for the Amazon $79.99, still a really good deal for this case. Now for this build, I went with an Intel i5-6400 Skylake processor coupled with an ASRock ATX Z170 Pro 4S. Now if you know your chipsets, you're going to say, why would you go with a Z170 motherboard when you have a locked processor? Because the 6400, which comes with a cooler, is a processor that you don't really overclock. It's not a K model. Well, the reason being is with this motherboard, you're allowing yourself to upgrade in the future. What I love about this motherboard is it having dual channel memory support, 4 slots for DDR4, and also SLI or Crossfire support. So in the future, if you wanted to add a graphics card or just simply run two of any graphics card, this motherboard will allow it. In the future, if you wanted to upgrade to a 6600K or a 6700K, let's say if you're doing video editing, you'll already have the platform for it. So it makes more sense to spend an extra $20 now instead of having to rebuild a whole machine. So my opinion is to go ahead and get the G170 chipset. You may never need the upgrade, but for $20 for future proofing, probably worth it. Honestly, the i5-6400 is a really good processor for gaming. Most of the time, 4 cores are all you're really going to need, and no games right now are really going to give it too much problems. Even in most CPU intensive games like City Skylines, this processor does fairly well with, so you should run into no problems at all. Alright, now let's talk about storage. I would say if you're going to spend $700 for a computer, one thing you might want to do is get an SSD. But SSDs are small in size, so we also couple that with a Western Digital Blue. Little fun fact, Western Digital Blues are made for up to 8 hours a day of use. So unless you're gaming 10 hours a day, a Western Digital Blue is a great drive for you. And everybody takes breaks, so that's perfectly fine. Now when we're talking about the SSD, we got a Kingston A400. The special thing about this SSD is its form factor. That doesn't really matter to us, but it's on sale, $44.99. We're talking lightning fast boot speeds compared to any 7200 RPM drive. To put it in perspective, let's just say 7200 RPM drives run somewhere between 100 and 125 megabytes read-write speed, whereas an SSD like this will run a 500 megabyte read and a 350 megabyte write. As you can see, just by simple numbers, this drive will outperform it. And with 120 gigabytes, you can have one or two games on there along with your OS, and you can put everything else that's not so hard drive demanding on your 1 terabyte Western Digital. Now with storage out of the way, it's time to talk about something really interesting, your GPU. For the graphics card for this computer, I went with the Asus Strix RX 470 Overclock 4GB graphics card. Now if you go over the Newegg right now, they're running a sale, and upon putting the card in your cart, you will see that it is $169.99 with a $20 mail-in rebate. For the $700 price tag, I didn't take in consideration the rebate, but that'll knock you another $20 off if you take advantage of it. Shipping is free, of course, and with this RX 470, you're going to get some really good gaming performance. When I tested this GPU, it was a beast for its price at $200. So at this price, I think it's a steal. And for the RAM, I went with Patriot Viper Elite with these silver heat spreaders here. This is 8 gigs of DDR4. Now you can always upgrade it later as the motherboard has 4 slots, but I think this RAM looks really cool and I think it's going to look really awesome in her case with that wraparound window. You can pick them up for under 50 bucks. And the last thing is your PSU, and I'm going with a 500 watt EVGA 80+. Just like a lot of these parts, I've purchased this before. This system's only using something like 280 watts, so a 500 watt power supply is a good fit. If you were considering going with SLI in the future, you might want to get something a little bigger, but the 500 is good for now, and EVGA make very solid power supplies, so you're not going to run into any problems. But that's the end of the $700 PC build. That puts us about $703.92 plus a $20 mail-in rebate, which, like I said in the beginning of the video, this is a computer that would make everyone happy. It's got great performance, it's got room for upgrades, and it's very sharp looking. You can even pay an extra 20 bucks to get a nice little LED magnetic strip, put a remote control, put that in there, and you'll have something truly special. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed. This is Andrew at Elite Gaming HQ. Please hit that sub and that like button. Leave any comments below if maybe you want to go with a different part, and I'll check out your suggestions. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Thanks, guys.